Bismillah wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. How is it that a people could claim they love Ahlul Bayt? How is it a people claim that they could be from a victorious group that aids the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? How is it a people could claim that they love Islam or they're a part of Islam, but yet they curse the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in? How is it a people could believe that they're upon the truth, could believe that they're upon good, and they curse the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? How is it a people could claim they're from Ahlul Bayt or claim they love the people of Ahlul Bayt, but yet they curse the beloved, the most beloved woman to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha? How is it a people could believe that they will be successful in this life as well as the hereafter when they say the things they say about Abu Bakr or Umar or Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu majma'in, and their false claims that they love Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu when they don't accept the fact that he took bay'ah to those other companions, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, and they don't accept the fact that he was a companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that he was not to be worshipped, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, and that he was a person who loved his companions and the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and didn't curse them. How is it they can claim that they love? This is false love. This is in fact hatred and bughd for the sunnah and bughd for Ahlul Sunnah. This is hatred and inhiraf and aqidah. So how is it that a people could believe they'll be successful when they hold these beliefs? How is it a people could believe they're successful when their awwala and their awwala wal bara is for other than Islam and Ahlul Islam? You don't love the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam with the companions radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, la tusubbu ashabi. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered us not to curse his companions. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said that if we were to spend the amount of Mount Uhud in gold, that it would not be anything like the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is because of their suhbah, because they were close to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and their fada'il, because of their benefits and their closeness and their righteousness, that none of us can even come close to being on their level in understanding the religion. They were there when the revelation was revealed, and they are the carriers of the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless them all, to be pleased with all of them, and bless them all to be inhabitants of Jannah to Firdaus. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala join us to be with them, and to meet them, and to be of those people who advance His blessed sunnah and the sunnah of His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala humiliate those people who try to humiliate the people of the sunnah, sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wasallam, ala nabiyyina Muhammad.